They don't know about us. They don't know about us.
How could they know?
They don't know about us. They don't know about us.
Thank you for autographs and the cheers. Over the years, you stood by me. You didn't doubt. I think you want some more. I do more than sing. I'm out now, acting out. Looks like I'm my own movie now. After all the words that they gave me, you stood by me. You didn't play me, you didn't doubt. I think you want some more. I truly believe that if it wasn't for you, I don't know what I would do.
You and me. 45 minutes after the hour. They don't know about you and me. That's Chris Get Down, Brian and Aaliyah checking in with They Don't Know. And you're in the midst of the Sunrise Online Morning Show. 45 minutes after the hour. If you have to make it there by the top of the hour, you have 15 minutes to make it on your way. Shouts out to our affiliates across the country. ocityfmHD in Oklahoma City. Grown Folks Radio in Miami, Florida. Chico to Leo and them. What's happening? Sky City Radio. Roy and my family down in Georgia. WBDR Radio in Meridian, Mississippi. Bumps Radio in Leicester, UK. 365 Jams in Montgomery, Alabama. KPLX 94.9 FM in Ruston, Louisiana. Chill Radio in London, England. KZPI 94.3 FM in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. WRFN 102.5 in London, England. Flex 103 FM in New York City. Money earning Mount Vernon. JC and the family, stand up. And also, we can't forget about our latest affiliate, our latest from the City of Angel, Wes Up, 98.2 The Beat in Los Angeles. My man, DJ No Mike, is on the scene, the program director up in Minneapolis, checking in with us. Good morning, my man, Mike. What's happening, bruh? We rolling. Well, Chuck, Joan Rivers, man. Joan Rivers. First of all, do you think Joan Rivers is a good comedian?
Oh yeah, she, I mean, she's all right.
Yeah,
she's all right. I mean, you know, it's not about being funny; it's about being who you are and saying what's on your mind and saying it. You know, that's like basically what comedians are. Because there's
sure.
A lot of comedians. A lot of times, a lot of people say, "Well, I think I'm funnier than him." But it ain't about being funny; it's about feeling the personality and a persona that sells. You know,
sure.
You know, that's all.
Right. It's just a complete package. I understand. Well, legendary comedian Joan Rivers is infamous for being pretty cruel when it comes to critiquing the looks of her fellow celebrities. But her latest insult, did she go too far? Now, according to an online report, during a recent stand-up performance, Rivers went off on Kim Kardashian and Kanye West's baby daughter, calling her ugly. Now, God, she said... That baby is ugly. I've never seen a six-month-old so desperately in need of a waxing.
That baby's so hairy, huh? It's a hairy
baby. See, that baby is part gorilla. Now, this is not the first time the child of Kim Ye has been subjected to this kind of scrutiny. Last December, when Kardashian posted a photo of her daughter on Instagram, she was hit with a barrage of nasty comments, suggesting the child's eyebrows were too thick. So, Kim Kardashian tweeted and said, "Do you really think I would wax my daughter's eyebrows so young? I'd wait until she's at least 2, 2.5. Man, dig that. Now, Joan Rivers, obviously, she's a comedian, but since she called a little gorilla baby and called her ugly, should she do that, Chuck? Is that appropriate?
Oh, it's a cuter baby to me. I've seen the baby. Baby look good to me, you know. But you know, white people, especially the white women, you know, they don't like a lot of hair. So that's even why they always wax it and doing all that type of stuff. So I guess that's from her standards that the baby got too much hair.
Man, Joan Rivers is a walking water bottle. Old plastic ass. She's going to be trying to talk about somebody.
Oh, yeah, she did. She have a lot of plastic surgery.
Well, she ain't nothing but plastic. I mean, nothing and plastic. She walked to the grocery store, people like, paper and plastic. Oh, it's you, Miss Rivers. Oh, it's you. It's you. We thought you were a giant-ass water bottle, ma'am.
Well, I tell you what, you know how to get shows, because, you know, you got the show Fashion Police, where they sit back and criticize what people are wearing.
Right.
And it's a big hit on A&E or whatever station it is on, or Bravo. Or,
sure.
It's a hit. So, you know, she constantly likes to criticize people. You know, she's the female Don Wrinkle.
Right, right. Uh-huh. No doubt, man. No doubt. Well, she's getting that paper. And I tell you what, I tell you where you like Joan Rivers plastic very, very much. You like that plastic when she hits that bank. Well, I tell you, she got it. Oh, she got it. Well, you know, we're going to switch gears real quick, man. We're going to switch gears real quick. We're going to shift gears. Charlotte, North Carolina. Now, we've talked about this story for a while, man, especially when it first happened. Now, it is the situation of Mr. Jonathan Farrell. He was a 24-year-old man. He was shot and killed September 14th, 2013, by North Carolina police officer Randall Carrick after a wreck in Charlotte, North Carolina. Now, Farrell was unarmed. Police called the Farrell and Carrick's initial encounter appropriate and lawful. But in their statement late Saturday, they said the investigation showed that the subsequent shooting of Mr. Farrell was excessive and Carrick did not have lawful right to discharge his weapon during this encounter. Police said Carrick was charged with voluntary manslaughter. Now, a grand jury has indicted Charlotte police officer for voluntary manslaughter in the fatal shooting death of unarmed Florida A&M football player. The indictment came Monday after a judge ruled the North Carolina Attorney General's office could resubmit the case to a grand jury. Investigators say Randall Carrick shot 24-year-old Jonathan Farrell on September 14th as Farrell looked for help after a car crash. Let's examine this again, Shucky. This is one of the most... I hear cases all the time, and of course, it's shocking, but believable. This is one of the most shocking cases that I've ever seen or heard of in my life. This man had a car accident. He was searching for help. He approaches the police car and gets shot 10 times? I'm at an utter loss of words, man. What's your perspective on this case, man, as it continues to unfold, Sean?
It's like gun happy police officers. It could be gun happy or not really. You know, it's just now the first one you talked about. Was it a different state?
No, this is the same. This is all the same case.
It's the same case. The officer was because I didn't really get all the graphs of the story for me to really comment on it. I didn't get all of it.
Yeah, Jonathan Farrell was shot and killed by North Carolina police officer Randall Carrick after a wreck in North Carolina. Farrell was unarmed. Now, police said that Farrell and Carrick's initial response was appropriate but lawful. But in the statement late Saturday, they said that the subsequent investigation showed that it was excessive and he didn't have the right to shoot him. One of the things that they found out about the shooting is the trajectory of the bullets being fired were at a downward angle. They showed this man was on his knees, on the ground, being just slaughtered and murdered, basically. After he looked for help. After a lady called, a 911 woman panicked and called 911 and said that somebody was trying to break in her house.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this is a man who just had a car wreck. That's exactly what people do after they have cars. They go and break in people's houses. That's what they do. I know I had a good car wreck the other day, and that's exactly what I did. I had a car wreck. I ran up on a light pole. Damn near killed myself. And I just went to the neighbor's house, the closest one I could find, and broke into the house. That's what you do when you have a car wreck. You break into homes.
So they found the police officers guilty and excessive, right?
Well, initially, they found the guy. They refused to indict the guy. They refused to indict him, man, because they said It was justified. Now, they decided that the first grand jury was missing four members. They were missing four members, man. So, yeah, so they refiled.
They probably liked the police officer, or the police officer was a member of their family or some sort, and it's hard for them to indict it.
Yeah,
that's
man.
That's probably what it is. You know?
Well, it's a serious situation, man, and unfortunately, this man had to lose his life for justice to prevail. And man, I want to send love, peace, and a good karma to the family of Brother Jonathan Farrell, a young man who just graduated college from Florida A&M. Them Rattlers, yeah, Roy and them down there. My man Ron Fry. But you know, it's very, very unfortunate. I'm just stunned that this man would lose his life after having a car accident. What a just senseless way to go. Let's check in with Sherelle and Alexander O'Neill. They said you can get some of that loving during the week, but ain't nothing like that Saturday love. You know what it is. Sunrise Online, baby. We are the biggest, baddest name in morning shows. Wake up and good morning to you.
I think I was gonna see you again. See you ever.